Hipsters. These days you'll find them everywhere. At your favorite park, your neighborhood cafe, and even your local watering hole. Now, they're invading your labs. What does a labster look like? One can easily be recognized by their excessively tight lab coats. A new style, the flannel lab coat, is rapidly coming into fashion. The common labster is often observed wearing thick-rimmed safety glasses, worn many times in situations where safety glasses are not necessary. Many labsters wear science tattoos, such as this ironic protein composed of left-handed alpha helices, or this tribute to science hero Charles Darwin. Can you identify the labsters in this lineup? Oh no, my friend, he's not a labster. He's just European. Now, let's observe the labster within the laboratory environment. The labster's lab practices are oftentimes foolish, dangerous, or just plain stupid. The labster wears modified latex gloves, or oftentimes none, eschewing safety in the name of fashionable hands. This labster has converted her P10 into a fixed volume pipette that dispenses only one microliter. Although this method is highly inefficient, the labster readily taps it as fun. When given a selection of various reagents, the labster selects the cheapest and lowest grade reagent despite the availability of more refined options. Many labsters excessively rely on their iPhones for unnecessary and menial tasks. Ironically though, they choose to use an antiquated form of technology for listening to music rather than the iPod, a popular choice among today's researchers. Most labsters image their gels manually. Let's turn to another page in his notebook. Here we observe that the labster documents his work in drawings. Holy smokes! Look at all that fret efficiency. The scientific community recently saw the first experiment performed on tofu mice when a vegan labster devised a method to avoid working with the real animal. A labster typically spends at least 2 hours a day searching for journals with impact factors less than 0.5. Many female and sometimes male labsters claim to be bi-divisional, that is. Here, this female labster shares her love of fly genetics with her male companion, while other times she enjoys analyzing protein structures with her lady friend. Ever wonder what exactly a labster works on? Well, good luck figuring that out, because although you may be a highly educated scientist, you wouldn't understand it. Unlike you or me, the labster doesn't wait until the first of the month to receive a stipend. The labster's work is funded by a private source. So what is the best way to deal with the labster who ruins your favorite methods by adopting them as his own? It's best to practice patience and leave them to their own devices. They're not worth anyone's time or attention anyways. Well, there you have it, a glimpse into the life of a labster. Albeit outwardly baffling, you've now seen their modus operandi, and now you're prepared for when they show up in labs.